today a small video before we get into the big one. The small video is about clarified butter. I really like to use clarified butter. Of course, I use virgin olive oil, extra virgin olive oil, pomace, any type of olive oil, depending on the dish. But I really like to cook a lot with clarified butter. It really comes in handy. It has a high smoke temperature. It doesn't splatter because it's clarified. So what does clarifying mean? Well, clarifying means that you remove some of the items that are in the butter that are not beneficial for cooking necessarily. And those two main items, there's of course many more parts in butter, but the three main parts in butter is oil, cream, and water. The oil is what we want. And the cream we don't, because the cream burns. And you've seen that when you use a piece of butter that you put in your saute pan and it starts to foam at first, and then little flakes of cream start to flake off and they turn brown and eventually they might even turn black. So we don't want that cream. And then the other thing, the foam and the hissing and the sissing and sometimes even splattering, that's the water. Those are water droplets that are trying to escape the heat, trying to escape the oil, and they splatter all over the place. So you want that water out too. So how do you do that? Well, what you do is you take regular butter, and I like to take at least 5 to 6 pounds. You don't want to do it with 1 pound, it's just one stick. You want to make a volume. It keeps very well, so you can keep it in your refrigerator or even in the freezer in small Tupperware containers and use it as you go. And it doesn't have to be soft for you to use it. You can scoop it out with a spoon when it's hard, drop it in the pan, and it instantly melts. But what you do is you take 5-6 pounds of butter and you put it in a pan that it barely fits in. You don't want a wide pan, you want a narrow pan. And then you place that over really low heat. Now, a little tip, what I do is I let my butter come to room temperature first, and then I put it in my pan, and then I put it over the lowest setting that your stove has. You want it to go really, really slow. If you take ice cold butter from the refrigerator and you do it over medium or medium low heat, what usually happens is that when it separates, the cream will rise to the top, the water, which is most dense, will sink to the bottom, and in the middle you have the oil. So then what you have to do is you have to very carefully, with a ladle like this and a small container, you have to scoop off that cream that's floating on top. But if you allow your butter to get to room temperature first, and then you put it over really low heat and be patient, then what happens, as you can see right here, is that the water and the cream both sink to the bottom. And now the clarified butter is just floating on top. And if you real carefully remove that with a ladle, you have perfectly clarified butter. You can see that it has this beautiful golden color and it still smells and tastes like butter. I'm sure that you've heard of ghee before. Ghee is an Indian way of clarifying butter where they use a little bit more heat. So if you use a little bit more heat, your butter gets a little bit more of a nutty flavor instead of the typical butter flavor. This almost smells like butter cookies. It's really, really delicious and tasty. And another nice thing is that since we removed all the cream, we've also removed the part that contains lactose. So people that enjoy the flavor of butter but are lactose intolerant, they can actually have a little of this. Now, of course, it doesn't mean you can start slapping it on your bread and start eating it by the pound, but you can actually use it to cook in or use it for other purposes that you normally would use your butter. Just have to be careful you don't overdo it. So this right here just goes in the refrigerator. Now, when it goes into the refrigerator, it will look completely like butter again. It will turn solid and it will turn that blind yellow, if you will. But as soon as it melts, it returns to this oil again. And it is just absolutely phenomenal to cook fish in or meat, saute vegetables in it. Mushrooms are really, really delicious. So that's what you use your clarified butter for. Very easy, very simple, and very handy in the kitchen. So I hope you enjoyed this part, and come back for some other videos. Don't forget to click like, don't forget to subscribe, and click on the little bell, then you get a warning when I upload another video. So thank you very much for watching. Have a good day.